Ever seen those cool Russian nesting dolls? You open one up and there's another inside, then another, and another. Well, that's exactly how recursion works. Something that contains a smaller version of itself, repeating over and over, like an endless loop. Recursion is everywhere, in nature, art, and even programming. And today we'll use Scratch to draw one of the coolest recursive patterns, the Sierpinski Triangle. Imagine starting with a large triangle. Now remove the middle part, leaving behind three smaller triangles. If you repeat this process with each smaller triangle again and again, you create a stunning fractal pattern, a triangle made of triangles. Now let's bring this fractal to life in Scratch. So let's start by drawing a simple triangle in Scratch. You put down a wing green flag clicked, we point in direction 90, and then we just set the x to minus 180 and the y to minus 170. So it'll be somewhere like here, which will position the triangle correctly. And now we go to extensions, choose pen, and then bring a pen down so it starts drawing. Now we have three sides of the triangle, so we want to repeat three times. You're going to move 400 steps and turn 120 degrees to the left. Then for some finishing touches, we'll go back to pen and use an erase all to erase all our old drawings, and then pin up before the starting position. Now we can also customize it with a set pen color and a set pen size. So this color is already pretty good, and let's just set the pen size to 3. Also, we'll just hide the sprite and also put a block there just in case. And now let's look at our results. There we have it, a simple triangle. Right now our code only draws one fixed triangle at x minus 180, y minus 170 with a length of 400. But what if we want to draw smaller triangles recursively? Instead of using fixed values, we introduce three new variables so the triangle can be drawn at any position with any size. So our first one will be called x, then we got y, and finally we got length. Okay, let's modify our code. So here we put the x, and then the y, and we move length steps. Okay, and let's go up and let's set the x, the y, and the length, and let's set to the exact same values as before. Okay, let's test it out one more time, and as you can see, the results are the exact same, but now we can change the values dynamically. Now we need to draw another triangle inside the first one, but in the opposite direction. So let's create a custom block. We're gonna call it draw multiple triangles, and then x, y, and then length. And here you can see run without screen refresh. So basically, if you want to run it instantly, then click on this, but we just want to see the process, so we'll click on OK. So here we'll do a go to again, go to x, y, and then point in direction. This time we'll say 30. Then again, we come in with the pen down and we repeat three times, move length steps, and then turn 120 degrees to the left. And at the end, we put down a pen up. Now let's call it inside our main script. So we go to my blocks, we drag it out, and then we're gonna do x plus the length divided by 2. X plus length divided by 2. And then y. And then length, we divide it by 2 one more time. So why are you dividing these by 2? Well, basically, we want half of this, so we want a triangle right here. So the length needs to be halved. Okay, let's test it out. And we can see a smaller triangle inside the first one. Kind of looks like the Triforce. So we only have two triangles right now, but we want it to keep splitting into smaller ones. Each new triangle will be half the size of the previous ones and placed in three key positions. So let's go down here, and then we can just duplicate this, bring it up, and we can just switch these out for the variables we have here. Alright, nice. Now we just duplicate it two more times, and then for the first one, we'll just do x minus length divided by 2 instead of plus length divided by 2. And then for the second one, we'll do x, and then for our y, we'll do y plus length times square root of 3. And let's put that in there. And we also have to add a divide by 2 for this part. Okay, now let's test it out. As you can see, it's working. We're making smaller triangles, but only in one of the triangles. And we want this to happen in every single one of these triangles. So we need to add iterations. So here we'll edit. We'll add a new label called iteration. And then add an input also called iteration. There we go. Then down here, we'll just set iteration to 5 or whatever you want. And here we have some blanks here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna say iteration minus 1. And this works for all three of our custom blocks. You just duplicate it 3 times and put them inside. Okay, and now we can put all of this in an if-then loop, which is if iteration is bigger than 0. Let's test it out now. And as you can see, we're drawing smaller triangles in every single one, and we got a nice size. 5 is a nice size. You should try it with 5, I think. And there we go, we have the triangle completed. Okay, so something you might have noticed is this, and this is pretty much the same thing. So we can create another custom block to fix this. Let's call it draw single triangle. X, X, Y, Y, and then we got length, and finally we got direction. Okay, so it's basically just this code that we want. We can just duplicate this, bring it down here. We don't need this. And at the end, we're gonna add a pen up. And we can remove these and change them. So point in direction, direction, go to XX, YY, and then move length steps. And now we can just remove all of these blocks. Let's just put it to the side for now and put this in. And then we go XX, YY, length, and then direction. So we got 90 here and we go 90, and then we can put this back. Now we got some clean code here, and we can do the same right here. So let's take this out and put this back in. Draw a single triangle. XX, YY, length, and then direction. We have 30 here. We do 30, and then we can delete this. And let's clean up our blocks. We only got 73 blocks, so we got Sierpinski triangle under 100 blocks. Let's click on the green flag. Well, first, we should hide the variables. And click on the green flag, and we got this nice Sierpinski triangle going. Now, some of you might not like this taking so long, and that's an easy fix. You just go to edit, run without screen refresh. There you have it, instant Sierpinski triangle. Now, you of course can mod my code. You can have it be like a rainbow and change colors while it's being drawn, and you can add a bunch of other features too. Now, okay, some of you might think this is too much work, it's too much, so I have an alternative method for you. Okay, so at the start, it's pretty much the same guy. When green flag clicked, we do here pen up, so we pretty much can speed run this. Erase all, set pen color again, pretty nice color here. And then let's just set the pen size to 4. And of course you can change these if you like. Okay, so now we're gonna point in direction 30. And this time we're actually gonna start at x0, y0, so in the middle. So instead of calling 3 separate smaller triangles at different positions, this time we call the recursive function after drawing each side. So right now let's also add a hide, so let's hide it. And create a new function. Now this one's gonna be called draw triangle. And then length. And then no X or Y's, we don't need them. And of course you can use run without screen refresh again, okay? Again, we have a repeat 3 times, move length steps, and then we're gonna turn 120 degrees to the right, not the left this time. And then here we do pen down to start drawing again, and let's draw a triangle with a length of 150. There we go, one triangle. Okay, now to create the recursive effect, we call a draw triangle again with half the length right after drawing each line. So instead of just drawing a triangle, we modify our block so it continues drawing smaller triangles inside itself. So again, in our function, we make a new input called iteration, click on OK. So we'll do 6, and then we'll put a draw triangle here. So we'll do length divided by 2. And then again, iteration will be iteration minus 1. And just like last time, we had an if loop again, which states if iteration is bigger than 0. With this recursive setup, each triangle contains smaller triangles along its side. Okay, let's test it out. Now you can see we have a recursive fractal forming within the triangle's edges. So you can see our pen size is too much right now, so let's change it to something like 2. Let's try again. So as you can see, that's way too thick, so let's change it to something like 1. And then try again. And there you have the recursive fractal forming within the triangle's edges. Let's make it draw instantly, so we can have the whole fractal. And there we have one Sierpinski triangle. Now you want to repeat for creating a pattern. So we're gonna create a new variable, let's call it n. And let's just convert n to a slider. So here we got a slider, 0, well, that's not gonna work, and 100 is too much, so let's change the range from 1 to 6. And then down here, we're just gonna repeat n times. And we're gonna turn 360 divided by n to the right. And again, of course, you can modify the code if you want. So let's test that right now. So we got four of them, five, five, and then six, six. This one's especially cool. And there you have it, a Sierpinski triangle in Scratch, and this is the second method. So this one draws on top of itself, so you can see it's a bit pixelated. I prefer this method because it makes a nice pattern, but comment down below which one you prefer. And if you want to learn how to make more patterns, then watch this video.